sustained by the love of the Welcome to the celebration of life for Dave Shirey.
Please rise.
Speak your words and more.
Let's prepare ourselves now to honor the mortal remains of our brother David, acknowledging the promises of God that all who put their faith in our Lord Jesus will have the promise of everlasting life. Today we thank God for the gift of our brother David, and we ask God's blessing on our gathering. Let us pray. O God, our Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again to save us. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant David, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Let's be seated now and listen prayerfully to the Word of God.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice of wines, juicy, rich foods, and pure, choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all people, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy the death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day, it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we looked to save us. This is the Lord to whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Shine like the sun and hold you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that he may grant you in accord with the riches of his glory to be strengthened with the power through his Spirit in the inner self, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend with all the holy ones what is the breadth and the length and the height and the depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to accomplish far more than all we ask or imagine, by the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. On one occasion, Jesus spoke thus, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, for such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son but the Father, and no one knows the Father but the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Won't you be seated, please? On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines, juicy rich foods and pure choice wines. And why? On this mountain, the Lord will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. The Lord will destroy death forever. That's a promise. St. Paul, who came to know Jesus by a marvelous intervention, has come, by the time he's writing to the people of Ephesus, has come to a deep faith and an acknowledgement of what it means to belong to God, to be part of God's family. I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. I pray that he may grant you to be strengthened through the power of his Spirit in the inner self, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, and that you, rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend with all the holy ones, with all those who believe in Christ, how broad and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know that love which surpasses knowledge, so that you may be filled with the very fullness of God. David was a remarkable man, a perfectionist in his own way, a romantic, Jackie says. He was far more likely to tear up than she says. And can you imagine what it must have been like for her to live with a romantic perfectionist? Flowers, candy, diamonds, I don't know. He was endlessly social, happy to be in the company of others, willing and able to do for others who needed help. He brought a lot of fun with him wherever he went, and he loved to tease when he could get away with it, sometimes a tiny embarrassment, sometimes an action joke, like tying together his kids' or his grandkids' socks. He was smart, too, with an interest in current politics and political history. Maybe that interest and the reading that it led him to is what got him a seat on the library board some years ago. He was good at what he did for the paper company. Otherwise, how could he be the number one paper cutter operator at Georgia Pacific? He said so himself. All of his close family acknowledge that he showed them the resilience of a stubborn man. I suppose there were a few things that, because of his stubbornness, were closed subjects, like the Packers. He knew what he knew. And when he explained things to his sons, he could be counted on to produce examples, analogies that would help them understand what he was explaining about, and then another, and then another. What is most clear to me about this man is that he loved his wife and his sons and his daughters-in-law and his grandchildren, and that they love him. For me, this is the aspect of David's life that makes him a sort of a standout of a Christian man. There's not one of us who isn't affected by self-centeredness, but I have the impression that, stubbornness aside, he lived for his family. He loved to eat, they said, anything but marshmallows. But he especially loved to eat with them, with all of them or with one of them. He loved to travel, to go places and see things by car, by bike, by sailboat. And he loved to share that with his family and some close friends. He was proud of his family, enthusiastic about them, and dedicated to them. In Jesus and through him, God revealed that the very life of God is a life of communion, a life of love and trust and care and respect that spills over into the created world. God made humankind in his own likeness, made us for a life of communion with one another and with God. In Jesus, God showed us the way to a life of peace together, namely by taking care of one another and respecting our relationships for what they are. When the Son of God, who was with the Father from the beginning and will be so until forever, when the Son of God entered into time, taking a share of our humanity from the humanity of the Virgin Mary, he knew, he experienced the love of God for him. He never said in his heart, "I'll show the old man," because he was happy to be the beloved son of the Father. It never entered his mind to take over the Father's place. This is the kind of life for which we human beings are suited, supporting and encouraging one another, honoring our parents, and discovering, as Jesus shows us, our own unique place in the love of the Father for us, and looking after our sisters and brothers who need our help. That's what we are made for. That's the life for which we are best suited. This is not difficult to understand once you have experienced love, once you have experienced an environment of love where you feel safe and appreciated and freed to love others. Jesus has loved us enough to take on our life with its limits, even the limits of our mortality. He lived for us, and trusting in the Father's love for him to carry him through death to a new kind of life, a fullness of life, he invites us to take on the yoke that will lift us up, the burden of putting our hope and our confidence in God as he did. And this so that we too may rise beyond our self-centeredness here and now, and beyond death itself in the heaven which is our destiny. Today, as you give thanks for this father and husband and grandfather of yours, we entrust him to the eternal care of God. And we ask for ourselves the guidance of God's word and our memories of what was best in our life with David, that we may enjoy with him the eternal promise of life and the reality one day in heaven. May David rest in peace. Amen. May he live forever in peace. Amen. Let's stand together for prayer. Let us call upon God, the Almighty Father, who raised Christ, his Son, from the dead, And let us pray for the salvation of the living and the dead. That God may guide the Christian people in faith and unity, that he may rescue the entire world from the evils of war and sickness and famine, that he may be pleased to show himself a father to our brothers and sisters who lack work or food or housing. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That God may be pleased to admit forever to the company of the saints his deceased servant David, who once through baptism received the promise of life eternal. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That on the last day he may raise up David, who fed on the body of Christ the bread of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That God may grant to the souls of our sisters and brothers, friends and benefactors, the reward of their labors and of their gifts of kindness to us. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That God may welcome into the light of his face all who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That he may grant his gracious help and comfort to our brothers and sisters who suffer affliction. We pray. Lord, hear our prayer. That he may be pleased to gather into his glorious kingdom all who have gathered here today in faith and devotion. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us lift up our own prayers now in silence. Support us, O Lord, all the day long, until the shadows lengthen and the busy world is hushed and the fever of life is ended and our day is done. Then in your loving kindness, grant us safe lodging, holy rest, and peace at the last, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Won't you be seated now as we prepare the altar for Holy Communion? Let's stand together once more and pray, dear brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of ours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant David, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Seated, whichever's better for you. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You have set us free.
There Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of Jesus' death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant David, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember all our beloved brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we too may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Let's stand together once more. God loves each of us in a unique and wonderful way. He loves us all because we belong to him. Now we pray together for ourselves and one another as Jesus our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Yes, Lord, deliver us, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. I invite you now to turn toward those around you and offer some gesture of peace. Peace be with you, my friend. invite you to kneel or be seated once more. And as we receive communion here today, those who are going to receive communion, those who are prepared to receive communion, may stand in your place, and one of us will come to give you communion. The others may remain seated. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let's stand finally and pray. O Lord, our God, your Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey. Mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother David may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, we sing a traditional song, at least we're not all going to sing it, but someone will sing it for us. A song of hope for David and hope for us, that the promises of Christ will be realized, and that the great crowd of all those who have gone before us in faith will be there to welcome him and to welcome us. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we entrust our brother David, in the sure and certain hope that with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you bestowed upon him in this life and on us through him. These are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with all who belong to you in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn to us, listen to our prayer. Open the gates of paradise to this your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother David once more, forever. We pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. Father O'Leary, who's been the pastor of St. Ambrose Parish for almost all of the time that Jackie and David have been here, who joined us today for this service. He and I are going to make the walk out, and then I think there might be an usher or two to dismiss the congregation, beginning with the back, so that it's all about the COVID thing, you know. And you folks will be the last. Thank you. So let us go in peace now.
Thanks be to God.
Chains are